Flags fly at half staff here at the federal courthouse in Norfolk and all across the nation as we honor Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
There are women who are ready, willing, and able to undergo the tough training at VMI, and they want that opportunity. The state of Virginia can't deny it to them.
That's Justice Ginsburg speaking to cadets at Virginia Military Institute 3 years ago. Of the 1,700 cadets enrolled there, only 13% are women. Women who were able to enter that rat line, as they call it, because of Ginsburg's landmark decision.
Like, it's been important to all of us, all of the females that went to VMI, that because of her, we could be here today. And we have the friendships that we have because of that and the respect amongst our male peers.
Virginia Beach resident Riley Neary graduated VMI last year. She remembers seeing Justice Ginsburg on a trip to D.C. as a cadet.
In the back with my uniform on, and I was like, oh my goodness, like just being able to be there and wearing what I was wearing, I was like, I stand for so much right now, and I know she can see me.
In 1996, Ginsburg helped strike down the Institute's male-only rule. She argued that it violated the 14th Amendment.
RBG took down the gate, and we stormed it.
Norfolk native Demetra Protegiro followed in her father and brother's footsteps in attending VMI.
The decision happened right when I was born, so I didn't know anything else.
She says she's honored to carry on a legacy of a strong force, pioneering women's rights and gender equality.
She did so much for me, not just VMI, but so much for women in general. Like, she was a trailblazer, and it's so sad to see her gone.
I'm Chelsea Donovan for News 3.
And now to the coronavirus in Hampton.